Hello, my beautiful soul tribe. Welcome back to my channel. This is Neetu. Today's pick a card reading is about our February month general energy check-in. So let's see how the month is going to be, how it is going to help you. Let's generally see how it is going to be. And as usual, I have three piles for you. Pile number one, two and three. And I'll also be placing the object on top of each pile so that you can select based on the object that you're drawn to as well. Before we do that, I just want to quickly tell you the overall energy that I'm feeling for the month of February is something related to I'm hearing unstuck, the word unstuck. You may be feeling the urge to take actions, take decisions and make a move, take a step forward and things like that. And your angels and guides are telling you, you know, before you take some big decisions, you got to really take a step back and look everything that is around it, in it, and everything or everybody that is involved with this particular thing that you are getting into or the decision that you are making. So they are basically telling you to take an informed decision. Don't take any decisions in hasty, because that is going to cost you. If you are not completely clear on what is that you want or what is that you are getting into, because I'm seeing a lot of energy, you know, towards getting the things done, taking actions, pushing yourself to take actions. Your angels and guides are telling it is good thing, but before you take any actions, before you take decisions, before you sign, before you do any major decisions in the month of February, be really clear and check the documents thoroughly and really do your background work before you actually get into the situation already. And and also they're telling you to be flexible with your plans. You know, things may not happen exactly the way you want, but it is certainly happening exactly how it should. So be flexible with your plan, be flexible to change your plan, be flexible and go with the flow is what the general energy and the message that I'm getting for you for the month of February, the overall energy. And now I'll be placing the object on top of each pile. For group number one, we have this beautiful shell here, and for group number two, this particular shell, and for group number three, we have this shell. Okay, so 1, 2, and 3, make your selection. Once you make your selection, you can scroll down into the description box and click on the timestamps that is with reference to your particular pile, and that is going to be your reading. I'll be starting with group number one now. Welcome, group number one. If you have selected this particular shell, this reading is for you. The first thing I'm hearing for you, group number one, is change turn of events, like unexpected turn of events is what I'm hearing, and this is going to be a blessing in disguise. So don't overlook that. Don't think that this is not happening the way you want, because there is going to be a change in the course of action, or there's something that is going to change the course of what you are doing or what is that you want to do. But you are still going to get the outcome that you desire, but just the steps that is shown to you is going to be a little different. All right, so be flexible with the plan is what I'm hearing for you, group number one. But let's see. And also I'm hearing like something is like the general message that I gave you, it mostly resonates all the messages with you. Like you, there is the things going to get unlocked, you're going to get blessed, or there is something that is getting unstuck or released. If you have applied for a loan or something, I'm hearing it is going to be approved or released. There is some sort of blessing that you really need. The help that you need is coming is what I'm hearing for you. Awareness and crown chakra. A lot of insights, and crown chakra is all about the wisdom and the knowledge, and also awareness. A lot of things are changing in your life, group number one. And 1 and 7. 1 is about the new beginning, and also the awareness is about the expansion off your awareness around what is happening in your life and taking informed decisions towards what is that you want to bring forth into your life. And crown chakra is about your connection with the divine, with the other side, and taking the signs and symbols and following the synchronistic events, and things are going to will be aligned to help you to move forward without much difficulty and confusion. And you are getting into this energy of being aware of what is happening around you so that you can take informed decisions towards whatever that you want to bring forth into your life. All right, this is absolutely related to your spiritual path for some of you, and for some of you it is related to your job or the career that you're choosing is in alignment to what is that you want, but or something new that is coming your way that is going to bring you back into alignment is what I'm hearing, because the divine is involved so strongly in your reading. I'm hearing things are going to be as they told, like turn of events, a sudden change in the plan, and that is for your good. Do not panic that things if things doesn't pan out the way you want. It is for your divine expansion and getting into the place of much more awareness and taking the informed decision, and that is for your own higher good. So do not worry, because there is going to be blessing in disguise. That is what I'm hearing for you very strongly, group number one. There is going to be blessing in disguise. If things are not working out exactly the way you want, it is for your good. Do not panic and worry is what I'm hearing for you. Okay, a thinking woman and anxiety. Exactly. You're going to overthink things when things are not working out for you, and you may get into this energy of anxiety. But your angels and guides are telling you, you don't need to panic. You don't have to worry, because it is going to be like a blessing in disguise for you. You'll still be achieving and doing things, whatever that you have planned for yourself. But it is going to be in a slightly different way, in a different route. You know, not just one road lead to your destination. There's going to be many roads that is going to lead to your destination, and divine is going to guide you to the road that has less problems and hurdles, and you have to honor and respect the changes or the change in plan or this blessing in disguise, and you got to really own it, accept it, and really go with the flow, and that will help you get out of this anxiety. Yeah, this is clearly giving me the idea of why you may feel anxiety, or that you have to revisit your plan, or you have to redo everything, and do not lose hope, because that is for your good, and that they're making me tell again and again, because you may get into anxiety if things are not working out your way. Okay, exchanging gifts. Look at that, gifts. There is some sort of blessing in disguise, some sort of gift, that has been handed over to you, some sort of a sudden change in plan, which is going to be very beneficial to you. Just honor that. Oh, look at that. We have blessed. There's a lot of divine intervention that is going on right now, and your angels and guides are telling you to really honor what is happening in your life right now. There is going for some of you, it is definitely about spiritual expansion. You're going through some sort of awakening, and there is temporary relief that you're going to feel because you have a long journey to go. I'm not going to lie, but you're going to get a momentary or a temporary relief or some sort of gift, there is a lot of blessings that are coming your way, and you are definitely reaching your highest potential. And they are not referring to just February. This is something they are talking about in a broader sense. Your consciousness is expanding drastically, and we have number 22, which is a master number. 2 + 2 = 4, and again things are you are looking for stability or security, some sort of confirmation, or this energy of finally I want to just root myself down or anchor myself, like something that is really stable where I'm certain of what I'm doing. And your angels and guides are telling that you will get to that place. You most certainly will get to that place, but as of now it is time for you to really really be going with the flow is what is going to help you, because there are a lot of blessed changes, beautiful events, there is some sort of surprise, blessings that are coming your way, blessing in disguise, and also I'm seeing waves, like things are coming in installment too. It is not going to bombard into your life all the blessings or all the manifestation that you're looking for as of now. It is going to come to you in installments, so that you integrate this part and then the next part will be shown. Like you're going to dance to the rhythm of the divine, and like you're going to co-create with the divine with harmony and peace. And that is a beautiful thing, because you're co-creating with the universe, and you're definitely in sync with all the signs and symbols. Just pay attention to all these details when things are not working out for you. Ask yourself why, or what is happening, what should I be aware of, because your consciousness is wide enough to understand this concept and grasp this concept and go with the flow. And that is going to help you a lot in the month of February. All I can say is you're going through a transformational phase. Yeah, it feels a little hard, but it is going to offer a lot to you in a long run. It is going to offer everything that that you want here on earth, to be living happily. But the primary work as of now is to expand your consciousness, is what I'm hearing. Expand your awareness, expand your mind, and not limit yourself. You have to leave your limiting beliefs and thoughts, everything aside. Maybe you're working on that right now, and it is definitely working in your favor. Just have a little more patience, because divine is absolutely they're right next to you and helping you and guiding you to go forward. So definitely expect some sort of gift, some sort of blessings, messages, change of events, turn of events, and sort of relaxing time as well. And don't panic if things are not panning out exactly the way you want. Just know that it is for your highest good, and things are going to be absolutely all right. Consult an expert. More information is needed. Contact someone with expertise in this area. Yeah, as we were talking about initially in the general reading, do not take any hasty decisions in the month of February. You need to really thoroughly check what is that you're getting into. Don't put yourself into the situation where you really don't have enough knowledge related to the subject that you are talking about or getting into. Really consult somebody who knows about it, and then probably you can take a step ahead. But that is something that you need to really look into before, if you are taking any decisions for yourself in the month of February. And then the last card we have, compassion for all. That includes you. Really be compassionate to yourself and know that you are doing everything that you can to help yourself, to better your life, to better your house, your family, and everything that involves you. And you are doing your best, and your angels and guides are telling you, be compassionate to yourself. And if somebody is really triggering you, know that they are only showing you their limited beliefs and thoughts. So there is nothing personal here, because everybody are playing out their own insecurities and fears onto others, and you are the bigger person here. With this amount of expanded consciousness and awareness of what truly everything is, I think you are in a better position than anybody else that you can come across in your surrounding, for you to be able to show compassion and love towards them, because that is going to put you in a very high vibration, and it is going to help you a lot to navigate very smooth in your life. All right, compassion is the beating heart of all spiritual practices. The peace you seek comes from the peace you create. Extend your compassion to all beings today, including yourself. Exactly, everyone benefits when you're kind. May all beings be happy and free. You're walking this path, for the ultimate freedom, for you to ultimately be happy without without others' influence. Already, even if you are not in the spiritual path, for people, others of you who are not resonating with spiritual path, you are going towards the ultimate freedom, financial freedom, freedom from your emotional blockages, worry, fear, anxiety, and stuff like that. You are definitely progressing. Don't think you are stuck. You are progressing, and the progression means different to everybody, and the stages are different. Phase is going to be different, but you are definitely progressing. Just be kind and compassionate to yourself, and everything is going to work out pretty well for you. Just take care of yourself. That's all I'm getting for you, group number one. If you have liked the video, please subscribe to my channel. See you in my next video. Love you all. Take care. Have a wonderful February. Happy Valentine's Day if you're celebrating one. See you. Bye-bye. Welcome, group number two. If you have selected this shell, this reading is for you. The word I'm hearing for you very strongly, something is going to be uncovered or revealed. Something will be shown to you. Maybe a clarity, maybe one of your questions or some of your questions will be answered from the divine or from your angels and guides or somebody that you are seeking advice from. There is going to be some sort of clarity, uncovering. Maybe you will know something that you have been wanting to know for quite some time. I'm not sure. Oh, look at that. We have a harmony. Maybe you're seeking answers about your love life or relationship. Passion ignited. Yeah, something is going to be ignited. Something, something will be revealed. So you're going to confront the other person, or other person is going to confront, or there is something. If there has been a disharmony in your family life, in your relationship, there is going to be a period of confrontation, or you're going to talk your heart out and you're going to clear the air, and things are going to get back to harmony. All right. Overall harmony is what I'm seeing. Some sort of revelation is going to bring harmony. Like everything is there in the open, as an open book. Everything will be shown, and you know exactly what is the truth, and that will bring back the harmony into your life. Like, finally I know what I'm supposed to do. For some of you, it is about clarity. If you have been seeking clarity about a person, whether this person is for me, should I be making a move, or what is happening with this relationship, is it dying, and things like that, definitely there is going to be some sort of clarity that you will be going towards, and something will be revealed to you which will answer your questions. Your questions will be answered, your prayers will be answered. If you have been questioning something, there is some sort of answer and the revelation that is coming towards you. All right, for others of you, you are going to find your passion. You are going to find that space where you feel completely yourself. Like you can just go there and sing like a bird and dance. That is the kind of energy you're going to tap into in the month of February, where you will feel ignited, passionate about whatever you're doing. For others of you, it is definitely about a passionate relationship, all right, and also it is a month of love, of Valentine's month, and a Valentine's Day that is coming up. There is definitely some sort of ignited passion that you can expect between you and the other one. There is definitely harmony, love, ignited passion, some amazing stuff. That's all I can say, because I'm hearing many words. I really can't say that out loud here, but yeah, there's going to be pretty amazing moments that you're going to spend with your loved one, especially celebrations. I'm seeing celebrations. There can be a proposal also, so this is turning to be a love reading. For some of you, it is definitely something is getting into next step. All right, maybe you can expect a proposal or something like that. But yeah, it is going to be pretty harmonious relationship situation that is going on. For others of you, you are going to tap into your creative energy, your space of passion, your space of you being you, and you are absolutely okay with your uniqueness, and that is the space you are getting into. The temple path, look at the beauty. Look at the beautiful temple. This is the spiritual path. This is the ultimate connection, the love connection that you can expect if you're talking or if you're thinking about love situation here. This is the divine connection, is what I can say. Look at that. Angel of love. This turns out to be a love reading. Group number two. Cupid in action. Yeah. For some of you, you can definitely expect a proposal out of, you may not be expecting it this soon. Maybe things are going to pick up phase and things are going to work out very fast for you, group number two. If you are worried or if you are thinking about relationships, some sort of revelation, some sort of truth that has been revealed, or you both are going to get into harmonious relationship. An angel of love here. She's showering love all over your reading. You know, whichever area you felt a disharmony in life, the harmony is being restored, is being brought back into your life with this ignited passion. All right. This is the month of some I'm trying to find a word that can really helps me to explain it in a better way, but I don't think so. Okay, let us keep it with love and harmony as of now. But yeah, a lot of harmony that is coming your way. No place like home. You finally build that nest for both of you, like you're planning your next step. That is what I'm getting so strongly. For most of you, you're planning your next step, your next move, or the other person is planning the next step or the next move towards what is that you want in life with this particular person. And maybe they haven't spoken out yet, but February is the month where you can expect them, you know, like talking to you and telling you their visions, ideas, you know, of what is the day are looking for in life or in this relationship or in this love. But I see things going to the next level, all right, taking things to the next level, next step. And this is going to be very harmonious and very sweet relationship that I'm seeing, with so much of passion, harmony, and the temple path is the divine unity, divine union. You finally are going to meet that person, or you will see all the signs that you are in the right direction. That is what I'm seeing for you. If people who are not resonating meeting with the relationship, all I can say is you are getting into alignment with your truth, with your own self, with your own divinity. Finally, you feel like you are comfortable being you. You are comfortable owning up your abilities, your skill, your talent, your uniqueness, and your quirky side of who you are. And you're going to own up everything. And you absolutely get into this energy of being you 100% without having to wait for others to validate. And that is what is going to put you in this energy of manifesting your dreams and desires of whatever that you're holding in your mind, in your thoughts, in your vision boards, or whatever that you're doing to manifest things. And this is absolutely beautiful. The accelerated momentum is what I'm hearing. Accelerated momentum for you, group number two. February is truly the beautiful, lovely month for you. And I'm really happy and excited. Let's see what is going to happen here and now. The past is in the past. You are going towards the future, but your angels and guides are telling you, you know, be here and now. Really, really enjoy everything that is happening around you, because there is so much of beauty within you, within others, and in your surrounding. You really have to pay attention to all that is going on, and things are absolutely turning out to be very beautiful. In fact, I'm seeing honey and milk. That is such a wonderful combination, honey and milk. Like life is finally getting back to its sweetness, to its glory is what I'm hearing. And they want you to stay present, right? Don't overthink things. Don't exaggerate things in your mind, you know, because you may get overexcited, and you may lose sight of what is that you really want in life. You know, like they want you to be really present and really be aware of what is that it is coming, so that you can enjoy the beauty of it, all right? They want you to be present and receive all these blessings, especially with related to relationships. Really be there when that person proposes you. Just don't you know, wandering around in your mind. That is what they're telling. They want you to anchor down and really feel the moment, really feel the situation, really feel the person, really feel your own emotions, really feel your feet on the ground. Stay anchored and grounded, because this is highly exciting sort of situation got going on, and they don't want you to lose the moment by overthinking things, if that makes sense. That is what I'm hearing. All right, I'm just trying to convey it in the best way possible that I can. Look at that, we have the new dawn. For others of you, if you are not really relating to relationship, this is about the new start, the new dawn. February is going to be really exciting, a month for you where your passion will be ignited, where you will be in alignment to your true self, where you will feel really called to do things, called to take care of yourself. You'll be called to go to places, visit different places, meet new people, really be there and enjoy the moment. That is what I'm hearing for you, group number two. Wow, this is just truly amazing. The worst is now behind you. Positive new experiences are on the horizon. Perfect. That is so perfect message for you. A new experience are on the horizon, and I really wish that you grab hold of all these beautiful things into your life. And the last card that we have is, it's time to stop procrastinating. And then the time is now, or rather that is the right way to put it across. The time is now. I'm sorry if you're hearing my dog barking. He just woke up, he's outside and he started barking. It's time to stop procrastinating, and what I'm hearing is, it's time for you to allow yourself to receive all those beautiful things into your life, because it's time for you to be happy. It's time for you to leave the past behind. It's time for you to mend things. I'm hearing mending things. I'm hearing amending, amendments, making things right. If you have not spoken to a person, it's time for you to forgive and really go and hug that person and tell, you know what, it's all right. And a lot of things getting mended and getting restored is what I'm hearing. Your current obligations and responsibilities can no longer be put off. It's time to buckle down and do the work. The resolution and abundance you seek requires action. Ignore any naysaying voices. Believe in yourself, you can do this. Don't fear that you cannot do, because putting things off is only the result of you fearing what if it doesn't work out. And it's time for you to really take a jump, take a leap, and do what needs to be done. You'll be so relieved and proud when this is behind you. Exactly, the time is now. The time has come for you to take leap of faith. It's time for you to take things to the next level. There's time for you to really enjoy and be happy, to be here and now, to be in this moment and really enjoy the sweetness of life, and really be here to do that. And don't overthink things, because things are absolutely working out perfectly all right, perfectly fine, because you did the work, and it's time for you to get into the next phase of life. And angel of love is here to bless you with all the love that she can, for you to reach this divine union, harmony, peace and love into your life. And that is what I have for you, the messages that I have for you in the month of February. I wish you a wonderful Valentine's Day. I love you all. Take care, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye. Welcome, group number three. If you have selected the shell, this reading is for you. What I'm hearing is the word is like going back and forth. You may go back and forth on certain topic, subject, or certain decision that you may have to take in the month of February. Your angels and guides are telling you to really do your work before taking any decisions. Going back and forth is fine, but once you decide, you decide. No going back. Wow, that came out very strongly. That is what they're telling, you know, like you take all the time that you want to take a decision, but once you take a decision, and you have to, you got to stick to that, only then you can see progress or success or whatever that the situation involves. Let's see. Okay, spiritual union, spiritual strength. Look at that, a lot of spirituality going on here. Even group number two had something related to spiritual union. This is about two of cups in general. This is soulmate energy and spiritual strength. There is a lot of strength. Maybe you are in the crossroad of taking certain decision related to somebody or something. Or it could be related to you also. Maybe you are in the phase of taking certain decision is what I feel and is what I'm hearing. Maybe you're in the crossroads. So it is time for you to take certain decisions. Don't doubt your abilities is what I'm hearing. You got what it takes to do what is that you have in mind. Do not overthink things. You got to take a plunge and see where it takes you. Because everything will come to your life only to teach you or to just tell you what is that you're, what is that not meant for you. And there is nothing to be worried about, scared about, because everything has its own messages, its own lessons that it brings along with it. Don't overthink things because they're telling you got what it takes to do what is that you're planning to do. It's all right for you to take time to think through things or to do all variety of things before you arrive here. But there comes a time when you really have to take certain decision and there will be no choices left. And that's all right. But they just want to confirm you that you really have what it takes. And do not underestimate yourself and don't overthink. And if it is about other person, if you think that the person really do I deserve this person? Am I worthy of this person? Your angels and guides are telling you, that is a wrong question to start altogether. You are created by the divine. And you got the essence of the divine. And this is the wrong question for you to be really pondering upon because you are absolutely beautiful, unique and perfect the way you are. You don't have to really worry whether the other person is going to like you or do you match the other person's criteria and things like that because it really doesn't matter. The divine union or the spiritual union is all about the yin and yang coming together and making it as one whole. And if the right person comes into your life and there is no question the way you look, the way you act, the quirkiness, the craziness, it is all fine. It is just a matter of, I'm so sorry if you're hearing my dog barking. He just woke up. Yeah, so you don't have to worry about that at all. And your spiritual strength, you got enough support and strength that is required for you to move forward and take this action. All right, just don't overthink things because you're just doing. Oh, look at that. We have caring connection. Maybe some of you are really questioning about a person or thinking about the person, whether is this the right one. I think it is. All right, you got to trust yourself and take that action walking away. Okay, there are two sets of messages for some of you are inquiring about should I stay in this relationship or should I leave. And there is other group maybe inquiring or have this in mind that is this the relationship. And And what I'm hearing is this is a caring relationship that you are in. Yeah, they are telling you got to give it some more time. You got to take care of yourself and really build yourself up and see how it goes. This is it's all right. It's all right for you to not know the answer for some time. It's all right for you to go back and forth on the situation because you got to collect all the information and everything that you can do to really take this informed decision. But it's time for you to restore your own energy is what your angels and guides are telling you. If you're thinking about walking away from any relationship or from any situation, as of now, do not take the decision, but work on your own energy, work on you bettering yourself, empowering yourself, taking care of your power, taking care of your control on your relationship, and then you can slowly decide on whether to stay or whether to walk away. But this is time for you to gather your own spiritual power, your own spiritual strength. For others of you, who are really thinking about, am I really worth of this person and things like that, this you don't have to worry at all. This is going to be a caring, loving relationship, fork in the road. Absolutely, you guys are in the crossroad. There is no doubt about that. Okay, to the sea. Yeah, they're telling you to go with the flow as of now. Just go with the flow. You got this. That is what they're telling you. You have to go with the flow as of now. You don't have to take any decisions. Just keep going with the flow. You will know the answer. The direction will be shown. But at the same time, you got to work on yourself, in building up yourself, in order to build your spiritual strength, your ability, whatever is the case, whether you're getting into the relationship or you're walking away from the relationship, you know you are capable of doing it. There is no question, no second thought about it. All right, it is only the matter of you finding yourself in the process, not losing yourself. Wow, that is truly amazing. Whatever is the case, it is about you finding yourself. It is not about you losing yourself, whatever that means to you, and that is the answer. All right, and you have to believe whatever is happening in your life right now, because it is taking you to the place where you belong. And this is heavily moving towards relationship reading, because all the cards are indicating towards relationship. And February is a month is about love, Valentine's Day and stuff like that. Maybe your angels and guides want to address something related to relationship. But yeah, you are in the crossroad. They're telling you that you don't have to hurry, you don't have to take decision in haste. Take as much time as you want, but in this process, you got to build yourself up. You got to find yourself. You got to find your spiritual roots, spiritual strength, your own abilities, your own worth. And you have to find yourself first, and then take a decision whether to walk away for the people who are trying to walk away, or to stay in this relationship, or make a first move, or go talk to that person that you are interested, or whatever is the case. All right, so that is what I'm getting for you as of now. Just going with the flow is going to help you a lot, and help you to take the decision as well, because in the due time you'll know exactly what to do with this amount of empowerment and spiritual strength that you're going to gain in the process of finding yourself. There will be no confusion left, and you know exactly what to do. That is why they are telling you to just go with the flow as of now, and do what is that needs to be done to help yourself, not others, and you will know exactly what to do in due time. Protection. You, your loved ones, and your possessions are safe and protected by heaven. You are protected, all right? You are not going to get hurt. You are not going to get hurt, whatever is the case. You are protected. You are dearly taken care of. And for others of you who are really worried to get into the relationship, you are probably protecting your heart. You are only trying to protect yourself because you have been betrayed, or you have been played in the past. You don't want to repeat that pain again, but your angels and guides are telling you, you cannot be in this energy forever. All right, this earth here is to be is for you to enjoy. It is for you to open your heart and really take in all the beauty and love that it has to offer. You cannot guard yourself for very long. Let it go, and we are there to take care of you. And it's all right if you're going back and forth on the decision, but at some point you got to get into this energy of let me see what happens, and you're going to take that leap. But as of now, they are just telling you to believe. Just believe that things are going to be perfectly all right, and you are protected as well. That's why your angels and guides are brought you to this reading, so that you know that this is not the process of you walking away or getting into a relationship. This is the process of you finding your true worth, and then you're going to take a decision, whatever that decision means to you. Look at that. We have unicorn. Believe. You got to believe in your journey, all right? You got to believe that divine is guiding you and taking you to the place where you're supposed to go, and don't doubt it. There's magic all around you. Open up to the wonders of the universe. Notice the connections and synchronicities. Follow your feelings and believe with all your heart. We successfully manifest our dreams when our feelings are in alignment with our plans. From that sacred union, we have sacred union card here. From that sacred union, the right ideas take shape, the best relationships blossoms, and the stuff that's meant to be easily falls into place. Everything is possible. Yeah, exactly. You're getting into the divine union with yourself, with your own alignment, with your own soul progression, with your own self, and everything else will fall into place. You will know exactly what decision to be taken. You'll know when to walk away. You'll know when to stay. You'll know when to make a move. This is all about your spiritual union with yourself. It is about you taking, it is about you aligning yourself with your soul purpose, aligning yourself to your towards what is that you really want. It's all right for you to dwell in this uncertainty for a little bit, but it is going to go away once you step into your power, and you will know what is that you want, and you're going to go towards that. And that is what they're trying to tell you this whole reading. All right, yeah, that's all I'm getting for you, group number three. If you have liked the video, please subscribe to my channel. Happy Valentine's Day, and love you all. Take care. Happy February month. See you in my next video. Bye bye.